more breaking news for you. We told you about last hour, and more on it now. Russia's defense ministry claiming that Ukraine launched a massive attack in the Kursk region of Russia. That's an area largely unaffected by the 2.5-year war. The defense ministry says that several hundred Ukrainian troops attacked by land and air, with tanks and armored vehicles hitting Russian positions. Ukrainian officials so far not commenting on the Russian claim. Well, Nick Payton-Walsh joining me here in the studio with more. I mean, what more do we have at this point?
Yeah, I mean, look, there seems to have been a substantial incursion by the Ukrainians, who said nothing about this at all, but frankly, who else could it be? It's unclear what Ukrainian units might be behind this. Russian bloggers are suggesting this may actually be more official parts of the Ukrainian military. But all that aside, it has caused Vladimir Putin to have to make a pretty unusual statement, which is to talk about a major Ukrainian provocation and how they, he says, are firing on civilians indiscriminately. Mm. Bear in mind, Russia appears to be doing that on a daily basis inside of Ukraine. His chief of staff, Valery Gerasimov, has said that the Ukrainian advance has been halted. But there are videos showing it significantly far inside Russian borders, 5 kilometres at least, possibly more. Suggestions it could be even deeper, past a key town called Suzda. Now, that is important because it is a gas hub, some analysts say, for the supply of Russian gas through Ukraine onto Europe. It's still happening, even though this war is now in its third year. And there are some suggestions that this advance may be angled towards that, or it may simply be about trying to throw Russia into disarray. That's clearly happening. They were not expecting that in the slightest. There are suggestions from local officials that indeed we're now seeing Ukrainian forces inside the town of Suzda itself, possibly even having gone through it, continuing onwards north. Now, that this comes at an exceptionally complex time for Kiev. They are under great pressure on the Donetsk front lines near a town called Pokrovsk, a key military hub for them. They're losing there steadily but slowly. And there are other suggestions too that along that front line they're running out of manpower. So already today we're seeing Ukrainian observers going, well, what are you doing deep inside Russia if we're losing on other parts of the front line instead? All that aside, this is a rare moment of what you might call good news for Ukraine, where they're projecting strength, catching Moscow off guard, and presumably now forcing Russia to rush reinforcements around and change its calculus on the front lines.
You suggested that we are now 3 years into this war, and there are reports that significant elements of Ukrainian society are now wondering whether the government shouldn't be, the president shouldn't be, sitting down and finding an end to this conflict. Is that, anywhere close?
I think significant elements, I think it's probably there are more people thinking that that might be a good way forward than there were before. That's still the minority, I think. There's still intense animosity, obviously, amongst Ukraine society that's seen its military aid mails, decimated by this war and significant damage to vast parts of their country. But there is, I think, possibly a growing feeling that the way forward for Ukraine is less rosy than it has been. They're having manpower issues. Their weaponry supply is better than it has been. They've just got F-16s from NATO allies in the air now too. So they potentially have a cleaner road ahead in terms of their weaponry supply. But they're running out of people. Russia doesn't seem to be having that problem at all. But the front lines aren't really changing massively. We're seeing slow shifts in ways which matter hugely to frontline tacticians, but nothing that NATO allies would call strategic. And so I think there is a point here where maybe people are beginning to wonder, what is the long-term picture going to look like here? But things like this show Ukraine still wants to take the fight. And you may see more of this too, as the idea of a Trump administration nears, as the possibility that peace talks are talked of by us, something we haven't really thought about really for 3 years, that we see both sides trying to move quickly and establish superiority for those negotiations. Mm. But that's a far stretch at the moment here. I think, in short, we're seeing Russia confidently moving forwards, trying to improve its strategic positions in the Donetsk region, and then this possibly flash in the pan. We're seeing deep inside Russia pretty significant embarrassment. And I should point out, Ukraine has said nothing about this. We don't know who it is, but it's pretty clear what's going on there, Becky.
Nick Payton-Walsh on the story for you, Nick. Always a pleasure. Thank you.